Hello guys, it is Gate of Theories here, and the Beaker Girls has finally wrapped up now with its last episode the other day. So today, we are going to be reviewing the series as a whole, what worked and what didn't. If you want to see an in-depth review of each episode 1 through 5, then you can do so by either clicking the card up there, or there will be a link down below in the description. And before we go any further, please make sure that you click that red subscribe button down below, and have your notifications turned on so that you get notified every time we make any brand new Trace Beaker videos. So, the main question is, did I like it or did I hate it? And you'll be pleased to know I liked it. Really liked it. Comparing to other series, I'd say this beats My Mom Tracy Beaker and definitely the Dumping Ground Series 8 and 9. It's not perfect, but it's definitely something more hopeful for this franchise, which for a while now has been going downhill. Firstly, I think its strength is that it's a series and not a movie. My Mom Tracy Beaker was good in areas, but it was the rushest thing I think I've ever seen in my life. The first episode, we were meeting Jess and getting used to Tracy as a mum, then meeting Sean, seeing them date, and then suddenly they were engaged. Like, it was too quick to get my head around, and there was no room for the characters to breathe, and for the audience to even comprehend what was happening. The timing of the Beaker Girls, however, I thought worked really well, with some bits of fast moments like the first episode and the last episode, but also bits where it completely slowed down and allowed time for more emotion. The ones that come to mind are episode 2, where Tracy is with Jordan by the sea, and episode 4, where Jess is finally talking to her dad. I do think the show could have done with a few more episodes, or even longer episodes, but for the story they wanted to tell of Jordan moving in with the Beaker Girls, I think this works really well. But did this show do the one thing that I really hate that My Mom Tracy Beaker did religiously? This one improved slightly, but it still fell into the trap, and that is of sticking too close to the book. At the end of the day, a book is meant to be read, not seen on screen. So when it is put to screen, it needs to be adapted, and that means losing and changing some bits. The original show did this, taking ideas like Tracy playing Dare games, but then developing it for an episode. Tracy Beaker Returns and The Dumping Ground aren't even books at all, they just take inspiration from them, and I much prefer that. The problem with My Mom Tracy Beaker is it stuck so close to the book, it was like they'd copied and pasted it, and if you want to see my frustrations with that, you can go and check out my review for My Mom Tracy Beaker by either clicking the card up there, or there'll be a link down below in the description, because I get very annoyed by it. The Beaker Girls did unfortunately do this, but they did change it slightly, so it's an improvement. For example, we didn't get to see the side of Flo dating, and we didn't get a confirmation of Tracy and Peter being together, and Justine isn't pregnant in the book. But most of the other things were still in the book and weren't changed whatsoever for screen. It's an improvement as it means that the things that weren't used can be used for series 3 if we ever get it, but I'd honestly just prefer the book to be just used as inspiration rather than stick to it really closely to create your story. So let's go through some of the characters and storylines. Jess I really liked in this, and Emma Davies' acting is such an improvement from My Mom Tracy Beaker. All of the kids' acting abilities of course isn't as good as the adults, but it's still decent. The series was great because it dwelled more into Jess dealing with her own personal issues, rather than just focusing on her mum like the last series did, so I really liked this improvement. Her development with getting used to Jordan, learning more about her dad, and choosing between her dad and mum is done so well. There are a few things that don't exactly work, however. The school scenes, while funny, sometimes just aren't needed, and I feel like the time could have been used better somewhere else. Patience I just find incredibly cringy and annoying, and her fights with Jordan are just so unnecessary. Tyrone I liked returning, and how we developed a little more into his relationship with his family and Sean. However, again, like last time, it was so small. I just really hope that in series 3 they properly develop Tyrone more, and we get to see a bit more of his personal life, because he seems to be stuck in the same place as always. And I love the journey of Jess, especially in the last episode where she's willing to leave her dad to help Jordan. I think it's a great message. Speaking of Jordan, she is pretty decent too. I thought her storyline and learning to trust Tracy worked really well, and I loved the two parallel scenes of her running into the water in choosing to go with Tracy, and then later on in the show choosing to go with Jess. However, I just feel like sometimes her character was wasted in areas and rushed in others, and I think more episodes would have developed Jordan the most. Because we go from Jordan moving in, to Jordan running away, to her suddenly coming back, and we never really get any proper time to see the reasoning why all of this is happening. I get episode 5 is set months afterwards, but we don't really get to see the pain Jordan has faced in being alone for that time, and we don't even get a reason as to why she returned in the first place. I just hope if we do get series 3, we can get flashbacks to that, and give us a more of an explanation as to Jordan's past and why she's been the way that she is. And then there was so much setup that was just not acted on. The biggest one being Jordan drinking and getting drunk. It could have been so interesting to delve more into depression and addiction, especially on CBBC, but it's brought up and then completely forgotten. I honestly just think Jordan would have been made so much better if they'd have given her more episodes to focus on her as a new character, but I really do like the relationship she has with Tracy and Jess, and I'm looking forward to see where it goes in the future. The adults I also really like. Pierre is a nice addition, even if he's being played by yet another actor, and I think his awkward tense bits with Tracy work so well, as you can tell he really likes her, but also has to show some authority and responsibility. Justine and Sean I like as well, and even the crazy ending of Justine giving birth in the beach hut, I actually didn't mind either. I guess it was because it was a Christmas special, but for some reason it just works for me. The introduction of Jess's dad, Cy Martin, also worked really well for me, as we finally got to learn more about Tracy's backstory, and I just really hope we can get flashbacks to that dark time in the future. Flo, Cam, and Mary are all good too. They're not amazing as they're not the focus, but they're decent. But now, let's move on to the main Beaker girl herself, Tracy Beaker, who in this I thought was amazing for the majority, but other times was just incredibly stupid, which really annoyed me. Firstly, Danny Harmer absolutely nailed this, and you can tell. Her relationship and chemistry with Jess is brilliant, and it really does feel like Tracy is a mum. And the character development is great too. Learning to let go of Jess and allow her to see her dad is a great and hard journey for the character to go on, and it fits perfectly with her personality. But where it begins to sort of fall apart is when Tracy meets Jordan and how she handles it. I love how the show is finally going back into discussing disadvantaged kids and kids in care, as that's what I find so fascinating about this franchise. My Mum Tracy Beaker unfortunately didn't do that. You basically only watched it because you liked the character of Tracy Beaker, and that was about it. Whereas this one, we have Jordan here and Tracy, Justine and Peter all discussing life in care, with Cam and Mary giving insights into fostering, so it's a lot more interesting. And it should have been absolutely perfect. But for some reason, they made Tracy so stupid when reacting to any of this that it all just begins to fall apart. I'm all here for a good old Tracy plan. It's what makes these shows, and she's had some crazy plans before that have made some great television. Climbing on the roof, writing an article to get Sapphire's flat back, taking Lily to see her sisters, and loads more. With the majority of them ending with the right conclusion, but in a very, very bad way. But all of these plans have some sense to them at least, and you can see why Tracy would think it's the right way to go about it. However, here, her response is just taking Jordan in and assuming she can foster her, and it's done so stupidly that even the other characters are saying just how stupid Tracy is being. Episode 3, you have Cam and Mary coming in telling Tracy she's wrong, and Tracy for some reason just can't see why she's wrong and doesn't believe Peter that the police will come. Then it comes as a shock to her that Jordan runs away, steals her money, and that the police get involved in the end. Like, have we forgotten that Tracy spent her entire life in care, switching between foster homes, getting adopted, has experiences of running away from care and being homeless, and might I say, they mention all of this in the show, and yet she still does something so stupid that it ends in this? Like, Tracy Beaker is not thick at all. She's a very clever character. And then, if we're classing the other shows as continuity, we have Tracy literally being a care worker and signing off people to be fostered, but she just doesn't seem to take any of this experience with her into the show. Maybe this is a sign that Tracy Beaker returns and the Dumping Ground don't exist in the same universe as the Beaker Girls, but even then, this seems way too far and way too stupid for this character to go. Unfortunately, that kind of ruins a lot of the show for me, as it's Tracy who we're all meant to love, yet she does something that is just so out of character. And then another letdown, unfortunately, is that we had no returning characters. Adele is actually in the book and they didn't even bring her back like they did with Peter in My Mum Tracy Beaker. We saw Elaine and Louise in the Someday music video, but we didn't get them back. Like, it's what the fans wanted. We want these characters to return, but unfortunately they didn't. But I am still hopeful that hopefully if we get a series 3, all of these negatives will be picked up on or fixed, so I'm hoping we get it very soon. So, the Beaker Girls started strong, wrapped up everything great, and I loved the finale where it feels like all of these characters are a proper family. And I really did like it. There was just a few unfortunate things that really did let the show down for me, and unfortunately, one of the main issues focused on the main character. But anyway guys, that's the end of this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, make sure that you smash that like button down below and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Guys, let us know down below in the comments all of your thoughts about the Beaker Girls. Do you think it's an improvement from My Mum Tracy Beaker? Did you like it? Did you hate it? And do you agree with any of the points that I have said here in this video? Let me know all your thoughts down below. And as always, we've been here at Gate of Theories. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys later.